Here we are at Lesson 91 from the Workbook of A Course in Miracles. Lesson 91, Miracles Are Seen in Light. Miracles are seen in light. It is important to remember that miracles and vision necessarily go together. This needs repeating and frequent repeating. It is a central idea in your new thought system and the perception that it produces. The miracle is always there. Its presence is not caused by your vision. Its absence is not the result of your failure to see. It is only your awareness of miracles that is affected. You will see them in the light. You will not see them in the dark. To you then, light is crucial. While you remain in darkness, the miracle remains unseen. Thus, you are convinced it is not there. This follows from the premises from which the darkness comes. Denial of light leads to failure to perceive it. Denial of light leads to failure to perceive it. Failure to perceive light is to perceive darkness. The light is useless to you then, even though it is there. You cannot use it because its presence is unknown to you. And the seeming reality of the darkness makes the idea of light meaningless. To be told that what you do not see is there sounds like insanity. It is very difficult to become convinced that it is insanity not to see what is there, and to see what is not there instead. You do not doubt that the body's eyes can see. You do not doubt the images they show you are reality. Your faith lies in the darkness, not in the light. How can this be reversed? For you, it is impossible. But you are not alone in this. Your efforts, however little they may be, have strong support. Did you but realize how great this strength, your doubts would vanish. Today, we will devote ourselves to the attempt to let you feel this strength. When you have felt the strength in you, which makes all miracles within your easy reach, you will not doubt. The miracles your sense of weakness hides will leap into awareness when you feel the strength in you. Three times today, set aside 10 minutes for a quiet time in which you try to leave your weakness behind. This is accomplished very simply, as you instruct yourself that you are not a body. Faith goes to what you want, and you instruct your mind accordingly. Your will remains your teacher, and your will has all the strength to do what it desires. You can escape the body if you choose. You can experience the strength in you. Begin the longer practice periods with this statement of true cause and effect relationships. Miracles are seen in light. The body's eyes do not perceive light. But I am not a body. What am I? The question with which this statement ends is needed for our exercises today. What you think you are is a belief to be undone. But what you really are must be revealed to you. The belief you are a body calls for correction, being a mistake. The truth of what you are calls on the strength in you to bring to your awareness what the mistake conceals. If you are not a body, what are you? You need to be aware of what the Holy Spirit uses to replace the image of a body in your mind. You need to feel something to put your faith in as you lift it from the body. You need a real experience of something else, something more solid and more sure, more worthy of your faith, and really there. If you are not a body, what are you? Ask this in honesty, and then devote several minutes to allowing your mistaken thoughts about your attributes to be corrected, and their opposites to take their place. Say, for example, I am not weak, but strong. I am not helpless, but all-powerful. I am not limited, but unlimited. I am not doubtful, but certain. I am not an illusion, but reality. I cannot see in darkness, but in light. In the second phase of the exercise period, try to experience these truths about yourself. Concentrate particularly on the experience of strength. Remember that all sense of weakness is associated with the belief you are a body, a belief that is mistaken and deserves no faith. Try to remove your faith from it, if only for a moment. You will be accustomed to keeping faith with the more worthy in you as we go along. Relax for the rest of the practice period, confident that your efforts, however meager, are fully supported by the strength of God and all His thoughts. It is from them that your strength will come. It is through their strong support that you will feel the strength in you. They are united with you in this practice period, in which you share a purpose like their own. Theirs is the light in which you will see miracles, because their strength is yours. Their strength becomes your eyes that you may see. 5 or 6 times an hour, at reasonably regular intervals, remind yourself that miracles are seen in light. Also, be sure to meet temptation with today's idea. This form would be helpful for this special purpose. Miracles are seen in light. Let me not close my eyes because of this. That's lesson 91. Miracles are seen in light. If you'd like to read my commentary on the workbook this year, go to amytorresasim.com and click on Amy's blog. Namaste.